Look at these lazy bums. Lazy bum one. Lazy bum two. Aww, a stretch. So it is the end of 2020, almost. What do we have? 4 more days and then it's over. But as much as I'm a pessimist, I guess, and I don't think 2021 is gonna be much better than 2020. I somehow doubt it. I'm still glad that this year is over, even though this year flew by like, it flew by and dragged all at the same time. I don't know how that happens, but that's how it felt to me. It just felt super long, but also super short. Don't know. but yes, it's time for end of the year favorites. You guys know that I do a few favorites videos at the end of every year, and I'm starting it off with my top 5 beauty heroes favorite discoveries of 2020. I do this video every year. I've done one for 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. So the last 5 years, considering this month is my official 5-year anniversary of being a Beauty Heroes ambassador. So I did you know, reviews for them for a few months before that, and then I became an official ambassador in December of 2015. So 2016 was my first full year. So that's when I started doing these top 5 discovery videos. So these are the 5 products that to me are the best of what Beauty Heroes offered for 2020. I discovered some amazing brands this year, some things that became real forever favorites. and I just want to tell you about them. I do have a couple of honorable mentions because there are some things that I can't live without or that I thought were really, really great. That I think need to also be mentioned, but aren't part of my top 5. They're just like my honorable mentions. I mean, I seem to always have an honorable mention every year. I went back and I watched little bits of some of the old videos, and my video quality and sound quality has definitely improved, as has my makeup and skin just overall. Much improvement. Go back to the 2016 video, I'll link it below. Just, I seemed so, like, even less sure about myself. I don't know, I just seemed different in that video. But I mean, it's been 5 years. I've grown up, I guess. Though I was grown up then. I'm still, I'm just older. Anyway. So yes, 2020 brought us a lot of really great brands, a lot of really great discoveries. And I just want to talk to you guys about my favorite ones. So I guess I'll go, what order do I want to do this in? I guess I'll save my top 2. I bet you can probably guess what it is, what they are, even without looking in the description if you've been watching my channel and heard me talk about certain things. But we'll see. We'll see if you can guess what my top 2 favorites are. Guess, I guess. Guess in the comments before you look in the description, though you might have already looked in the description at this point. So my first one is the Blue Alchemy Botanic Retinol Cell Renewal Concentrate. So this is one of those you know, botanic retinol products. Last year, I did have the Graydon Full Moon Serum in my top picks. This actually beats that out because I find that this to be just much more effective, faster acting on my skin. I really like the scent of it. I think the color is not exactly the same as when I first opened it. I mean, it's a little bit older. And Blue Tansy can sometimes turn sort of like a greenish color the longer that it's open, but it still smells exactly the same. It still works the same for me. You know, with the little bit that I do have left. It's this really amazing, just like texture. I'm gonna leave the link for the Blue Alchemy. I'm gonna leave the link for all of the videos featuring all of these products down below so you can go back and watch my initial reviews if you want. But my skin in February, which was when this box was featured, so I used it all throughout January. I used all the other Blue Alchemy products as well. My skin just absolutely loves this line. It's continued to be a favorite. I love the Multi-C Serum, which is a previous discovery. It was discovery last year. I love the Botanic Retinol. I love the Oil Serum. I love the new body oil that they just released. Blue Alchemy, it's to me, what the Blue Alchemy line is it's kind of like Live Botanical, only on like sort of a much higher scale, I guess, or more active ingredients, more ingredients. They don't necessarily keep it affordable because they don't. I mean, Live Botanical somehow is able to mesh like affordable with high quality ingredients. But I feel like Blue Alchemy is sort of like the more luxurious or the more higher priced point version of Live Botanical. I feel the same way about both brands. I think they're both just really authentic to what they, you know, what they want to bring, you know, to consumers, the way that they do it, the ingredients that they use. I love both. Live Botanical's never been featured in Beauty Heroes, but I just kind of wanted to, I feel like that's a comparison I wanted to make, because when I think of Blue Alchemy, I do kind of feel, it feels like Live Botanical vibes. I mean, if you've tried both, let me know if you feel the same way, but I really love Blue Alchemy. I think they just make stellar products. Go watch my, you know, my review of all the other Blue Alchemy products, because I did do a full line review and my skin just loves them. The antioxidant serum as well is also a really wonderful oil serum. And you guys know I am very oil fatigued, but that one is very, very nice. Really like it. Okay, so then I also really loved the Lil Fox Hotsy. This one was featured in June. So Blue Alchemy's was February, this one is June, and this is just a really great vitamin C serum. Again, I love the one from Blue Alchemy. Ficlo has a really amazing vitamin C serum. I would say that those are my top three vitamin C picks, at least that I've tried so far. And this one again, this one's a little bit, I'm trying to close this up, but this is running down my hand. So I just wanted to show you like the texture of it. So it is, you know, a runnier of a texture of a vitamin C. It's not, I guess some of the other ones are more sort of like gel-like, but it works really fast on my skin. I did notice results pretty quickly, not as quick as the Fit Glow Vitamin C Serum and quicker than the Blue Alchemy one. So it's somewhere in between those two, but it works really well. It works really effectively. I really, really enjoyed this. I think I'm about halfway through this bottle, but just a really effective vitamin C serum if you're looking for one. I have found that the fastest results do come from vitamin C serums that tend to be of a higher price point. I do have some on my list that I want to try next year to sort of do a vitamin C like review roundup kind of thing. So I do have some that are on a more affordable price point and like a less, you know, less money, not as expensive, but I have found so far from the ones that I've tried, the ones in the higher price point do sort of make the fastest difference on my skin. And that's one, I think it's 150. I think they're all the same. I think the Ficlo one, the Blue Alchemy one, and the Lil Fox one are all in the same price point category, but they all work really effectively. I really love them all. And the Lil Fox Couture products. The Dewy Dream Beam was also featured, which is also a really, you know, really great product. And I really liked that one as well. Okay, so my third favorite was the Mukti 2-in-1 Resurfacing Exfoliant. This was the first time that I had tried Mukti. I'd wanted to try them forever. And I was actually, I don't know why, but I was kind of surprised to see them in Beauty Heroes. I just didn't think it was a brand that was on, you know, like Beauty Heroes' radar. But this was my favorite of the products that I've tried so far from Mukti, and it just happened to be a feature in the Beauty Heroes box. So this is the exfoliant. It's made with, I think, like three different kinds of lime or something, or maybe that's, three different kinds of lime. So it's got caviar lime, desert lime, and rainforest lime. It's got micro beads in it. And this really is a kind of product where you just sort of like let the product do the work. Again, go watch the demo that I did of this. You don't have to scrub very hard. You lightly massage it into damp skin and the particles do all the work. You don't need to press and like, you know, rub it really hard on your skin. I used it this morning. My skin is feeling, you know, super smooth. I feel like I'm slouching. I don't know if my camera was just up too high or what, but my last few videos I've felt like I'm like slouching, but I'm not meaning to. But yes, I really love that exfoliator. It smells incredible, like lime cucumber or like cucumber melon. You remember, you know, Bath & Body Works, that cucumber melon smell? It smells like that to me. It's like reminiscent of it, but more natural. It doesn't have that fake synthetic fragrance feel that that one does. But I love it. It makes my skin feel super smooth. It's really gentle. You don't have to press really hard, like I said. You just like really lightly rub it around the skin and just let the beads do the work. Beautiful, beautiful. One of my favorite exfoliants. I really love that formula. Okay, so we're down to the final two. Have you figured out what my final two products, my top two favorites are? I need some Jeopardy music. What is it? Do, 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 do. My cats are unamused. It's Free and True. Free and True was probably my favorite discovery of the entire year. Absolutely love the entire Free and True line. And these two especially, which were in the box, make my top two favorites because I think these products, again, they're really highly effective. They're beautifully formulated. The ingredients in them are wonderful and they are an affordable price point, which I think is also really awesome. So the Mama Pacha was this the hero? I can't remember. It's my hero. And then the Body Profit, which is the body serum, was the other product that was featured. So I'm just going to call them co-heroes because they were both full size in the box. I already used up my full bottle of Mama Pacha. I did buy more because this is definitely in my top picks of favorite moisturizers and one that I would continue to use if I decided to stop blogging because it made my skin feel really great. It never broke me out. There's nothing in here that irritates my skin. It just makes my skin feel hydrated and moisturized and incredible, and it works with every product that I used underneath it. Every combination of products. And then I did use an oil on top. So I did use the Freedom Fighter oil on top. So it works well with oil underneath, works well with oil on top. I sort of played around with different oils as I've used this with other products since I did finish the whole bottle. Love it. Works in the morning, works in the evening. Granted, I don't have super dry skin. I do have oilier, acne prone, can be combination, sometimes a little bit dehydrated skin, but it's never really like dry. So keep that in mind, I guess, if you are someone who does have much drier skin. Or if you have much drier skin and you have tried this, I would love to hear your experience with it, if it did work for you or not. So if you have anything that you'd like to share, definitely leave it down below because I'd love to know. But I absolutely loved this. I've got bottles waiting for me. I'm not gonna pump this one out because I haven't opened it yet and I'm not quite ready to get to it, but I have some waiting because I love that moisturizer. It is so, so good. So the other one is the Body Profit, which this I am almost done with. I'm like down to here. I've been interchanging it with some other body products that I've tried over the summer, but this has remained a favorite. Love the texture of this. Love how moisturized and hydrated it makes my skin feel. I'm just gonna rub this on the back of my legs because I actually think I forgot to use, oh no, I didn't shower today. So I was like, I forgot to use body oil after I showered, but I didn't shower today, I showered yesterday. But I've already bought a backup of this because I love it. It's just an amazing formula. And again, I don't get super dry legs, but they can get kind of, well, I mean, I guess they're dry. They can get kind of scaly, you know, after I shave my legs and if I don't do anything to them. Because for the longest time, I didn't use body oils or body creams or body lotions regularly. And I don't know, I didn't for some reason. And now that I have been using them regularly, my legs like crave all that moisture. So when I don't use them, it becomes very, you know, it's very noticeable when I don't. My legs just don't feel the same. They're much drier. They can sometimes get kind of itchy. And this is, again, at a super affordable price point, works really well, makes my legs feel really awesome. Smells really great. What is it? I think it's lemon balm that's in here or something. I can't remember, but it just smells so good. Feels so good. Definitely my top two favorites from Beauty Heroes, and definitely my favorite overall brand discovery from Beauty Heroes. Because there were a lot of brands in here that we've tried before. So like Ranavat was in January. I had tried that brand. Blue Alchemy was February. I had tried that before. Mukti was a brand, new brand to me, but I wouldn't say it was like an overall favorite brand discovery. Bathing Culture was also featured, but it was more like body stuff. And again, I loved it, but not like, I didn't think that it was just like change my life brand discovery. Lil Fox I knew of, Leilani I knew of, Just Rosebrook, Pie, One Love Organics, Biophile was November, and December was Iuna. So really Free and True was like the best brand discovery for me in like in anything. So in like any box that I tried, any new products that I tried, Free and True was definitely my favorite brand discovery of like the entire year. So loved that, love that. So then my two, what did I call them? Honorable mentions. Those words flew out of my brain for a minute. My two honorable mentions. One was the Bathing Culture Mist. We did get, what was it, a Neroli Mist. I've been long out of it. I finished it very quickly. I wish that came in a bigger bottle because I did really like that formula. I'm gonna leave a picture of it somewhere. Jazz hands. I really love that mist, and I'll definitely repurchase that in the future once I've gone through quite a few of my mists. Though that doesn't really stop me from buying other mists, so I should just buy it, but I also shouldn't. I did really like that. So if you are looking for a mist, I would highly recommend checking that one out, because I did really love that one and used it up very quickly because I just really enjoyed it. The other honorable mention is the Leilani Meliglow. This has been a favorite mask for a long, long time, long before it was featured in Beauty Heroes. I've talked about it, you know, in other capacities on my channel. I think I featured it in like a favorite mask duos video. So it was really cool to see Leilani being featured in Beauty Heroes. You know, Leilani for a long time wasn't featured in like any or very few select beauty boxes. I know they did Organic Bunny once, and then they were in, were they in Clean Beauty Box one time. So it's cool to see them on like a bigger scale to like a larger audience. And I don't know if that was intentional that they just weren't in any beauty boxes, or if there was just no interest for a long time or whatever. I don't know. I don't know what it was, but I'm happy to see them in Beauty Heroes and that the Meliglow was one of the products that was featured this year, because I love it. I'm trying to get my hands out of the way because I love it. It's the Illuminating Nectar Mask, and it's like honey and it's got fruits and mine's a little bit of like an older jar, but you can tell. Well loved. I think I've used like three of these masks, three jars of this over the years. Really love it. So it had to be an honorable mention because I didn't discover it this year, but it was, you know, it's been a favorite for a long time. So that's everything that I've got for this video for my Beauty Heroes top five of 2020. I always put this together, and I love featuring my favorite discoveries from Beauty Heroes, and I can't wait to see what 2021 brings. The January box is already going to be a favorite. It's a brand that's not new. And it is one that's been, at least in my comments, from what I've seen from you guys say, it's one that you guys have been requesting make a return. So I don't know, try to guess, I guess, but I can't confirm or deny anything. I probably shouldn't even share that much with you, but it's coming in a few days. So I think we're probably okay. But I mean, I highly recommend subscribing, even though you don't know what it is yet. I think that you guys will be excited. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this. I cannot wait to see what Genie brings us for 2021. I'm excited. There's lots of good things out there. Hopefully some new brand discoveries. I'd love to make another new brand, you know, favorite discovery like Free and True was for me this year. And thank you guys for being here, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.